My name's Perry Brown. I'm a retired Bob Marshall game warden. Did that for about 30 plus years. So I've had a lot of experience packing horses and mules. This is what I've learned over the years. Hopefully I can share it with you guys and it'll help you out a little bit. Today we're gonna talk a little bit about packing a horse or a mule. Today we have a mule that we're showing you. There's a couple different pack saddles you can use. This pack saddle we have here is called a Decker pack saddle. It has steel D-rings that you attach your load to. Some saddles are a sawbuck pack saddle. They got a wooden tree. They're a little bit lighter. Just whatever your mission is on and what you like to use. It's kind of just no real preference. Just whatever works for you at the time. So packing mules and horses and what kind of loads you put on them varies quite a bit. You could, it's all dependent on what your mission is and how you want to pack. A lot of times people will use these kind of pack boxes, which are really nice. They're easy to open when they're on the mule or horse. You can put stuff in and out of them. The problem with them is depending on what kind of gear you're bringing, on whether or not it's going to fit in those boxes. The other issue is you got to get the weights pretty even so they ride evenly on the mule. Otherwise the saddle's going to roll on it, and if you're on a steep hillside trail, you don't want the pack rolling or you're going to have a wreck and the horse or mule going off the side of the cliff. So you got to pay attention to how the loads are riding. This style is a mannied. You have a manny, which is this tarp. So it's a rectangle or big square manny. And then you manny up your loads. So if you have long materials or a whole bunch of different stuff that might not fit in a box, this is a better route to go. If you have a little bit of uneven weight, you can lift one higher on one side and one a little bit lower. Of course, the heavier one would be higher. The lighter one would hang lower so that it rides evenly. These styles are a lot easier to put on. We'll put one on the side. So this style has hooks. It's on these boxes. So all you have to do to put it on is just lift it up here and clip these hooks on. Some of them have a clip on the bottom that you can also hook to the cinch ring on the saddle, because if they get to running or bump into another tree, something, they can swing. But if they get to running and jumping, sometimes these hooks can come off. And that can be problematic in the backcountry too. So you gotta pay attention to what's happening behind you when you're leading your horses, pack horses or mules or that sort of thing. So they're really easy to go on and off. And they're really handy. So if you're gonna use a manny load, which is these are, we can show you how to wrap up a load here in a minute. But if you're gonna put a manny load up on a mule, so you got your sling ropes. These are called sling ropes. So there's a number of different type of ways that you can attach your load to the side of the mule using your sling ropes. This is called a basket hitch. So your load's gonna go in there and it's gonna support it like a basket. You could do a barrel hitch, which comes up to this ring, and then your back one makes another ring. If you've got maybe boards or something that you're putting diagonally on there. But this is the one I generally use most often, is the basket hitch. So then we're gonna pick our load up. And you gotta steady it on your mule. And then you're gonna tighten the main part up against the D-rings. And then you want to rock it back and forth, make sure it's tight. Otherwise, it's going to ride out away from the mule and not ride very good. Then you put the bottom part to support it. There's a lot of ways to tie this off. The way I do it is you push a loop through, reach through, grab the loose end, pull it tight. And then you can either just get rid of the extra rope. I like to put a half hitch, just put a twist so the loose end's on the inside. That way, if this rope catches on something, it's not going to undo your knot. And then you can just get rid of your extra rope, just tying it off. So that it's out of your way. Or you can tie. So this load, if it's riding down the trail and he bumps into something, it's gonna swing it sideways, which is a lot of times pretty good to have, so that it doesn't, it can rock back and forth and swing if they run into something. The other thing you can do is you can pull extra loop through if you want to tie the bottom down and go around your load. Go through this ring that's in a cinch made for this. And then tie it off same way. So now, when you get rid of your extra rope, so now it's not going to, if you don't want it to swing back and forth and hit when it hits something, now it's pretty solid. But if the mule runs into a tree, of course, it's going to push the mule rather than the load. And then if you have a problem, you just pull those loose ends through, pull this loose end through, you can get your load off quick. So that's the basics for packing a mule.